Good day, students. Welcome to math.serve.com. In this clip, we're going to be going over how to apply the mean value theorem in finding the C that satisfies its conclusion. This is number two of our unit four test on the application of derivatives. Okay, so problem two reads, given that f of x is equal to 2x to the third minus 4x plus 3, find the numbers C in negative 1, 2 that satisfy the mean value theorem for this function. So the assumption is that the initial conditions are already met. We can clearly see that this function is differentiable for all real numbers and is also continuous. So we know that the initial conditions are already met. So we are looking for the C or C's that satisfy the conclusion. All right. So our mean value theorem, let's review that, is as follows. MVT. So if f, some function f, okay, if f is continuous on the closed interval AB and differentiable on the open interval AB, there exists a C in AB such that f prime of C, the slope of the tangent line at x equals c, is equal to the average rate of change from a to b. F of b minus f of a divided by b minus a. All right. Okay, let's go ahead and do this. We're going to break this up into two parts. I'm going to do the derivative part in blue. I'm sorry, in green, f prime of c. And then I'll do the other part in blue, okay? Or let's do that in black. So this is the instantaneous rate of change at x equals c, and then the average rate of change. We'll do that part in black, okay? All right, now let's deal with this side first. Let's find f prime of c. So how do we do that? Let's recall what the function is. F of x is 2x to the third minus 4x plus 3. F prime of c simply means evaluate the derivative of this function at x equals c. Find the derivative, plug in c for x, and you are done. Okay? So we have f prime of x, the derivative, term by term differentiation. We're going to have 6x squared minus 4, derivative of 3, 0. So that follows that f prime of c is equal to 6c squared minus 4. So the instantaneous rate of change for the slope of the tangent line at x equals c is 6c squared minus 4. Okay, now let's go ahead and find the average rate of change. Let's divvy it up. And then we're going to set them equal to each other. All right, so here we need to know B, A, F of B, and F of A. So we have the interval, negative 1, 2, so this is A, and this is B. All right, so A is negative 1, B is 2. F of A is F of negative 1. So we're going to plug negative 1 into the original function, not the derivative. So be careful with that. So we have 2 times negative 1 to the third minus 4 times negative 1 plus 3. If you compute that using your order of operations, you end up with 11 as the value of f of a. F of b, we're going to evaluate the function, this original function at x equals 2. So we're going to have 2 times 2 to the third minus 4 times 2 plus 3. Compute that, you end up with 5. All right, now let's go ahead and find the average rate of change or the slope of the secant line. That's going to be f of 2 minus f of negative 1 over 2 minus negative 1. Okay, we already computed what f of 2 and f of negative 1 are, so we are going to have sorry, I got it switched around. F of 2 is 11, and F of negative 1 is 5. All right, so we'll just plug it into this formula right here. So we're going to have, let's see, F of 2 is 11 minus F of negative 1, 5 divided by 2 minus minus 1, which makes it 3. 11 minus 5 is 6 over 3, which is 2. So this is the average rate of change. This is the instantaneous rate of change. We're going to set them equal to each other. So we're going to be solving for the c, where 6c squared minus 4 equals the average rate of change 2. All right, let's go ahead and solve that. You add 4 to both sides. You have 6c squared equals 6. Divide by 6, c squared equals 1. When you take the square root, you're going to have c equals plus or minus the square root of 1, which is plus or minus 1. Okay, now before we identify our c's that satisfy the conclusion, let's ensure that these two values are in the interval negative 1, comma 2. So if you notice, negative 1 is an endpoint, so it must be excluded. Okay, so only positive 1 is in the interval negative 1, comma 2. Okay, the other value is an endpoint, and an endpoint is not included for the C's that satisfy the conclusion of the MVT. All right, so let's write down our final statement. The C that satisfies the conclusion of the mean value theorem, let's write as MVT, is C equals positive 1. All right, so that's that. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. We really appreciate it. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other cool tutorials such as this. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to include it in the comment section. More clips can be found on math.serve.com. Thanks again for watching, and have a wonderful day.